you ever feel that life is just an illusion? Or some sort of computer simulation? If your answer is yes, you would not be alone. Elon Musk and many scientists are fairly convinced we are just sophisticated self-aware computer programs. Astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson thinks the odds are 50-50 that we are living in a computer simulation. We simply don't understand much about our reality. It is possible that all of reality, including Earth and the universe, is an artificial simulation.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
If you, me, and every person and thing in the universe were actually characters in some giant computer game, we would not necessarily know it. This is of course just a theory that inspired many science fiction movies, and recently even a large Reddit group called Phatom Project. In addition, there is a growing number of researchers who believe they may find experimental evidence that we indeed live in a computer simulation. For example, if the world is inherently smooth, or if, at the smallest scales, it might be made up of discrete chunks, a bit like the pixels in a digital image. If we determine that the world is pixelated in this way, this could be evidence that it was created artificially. What if scientists confirmed that we are living in a simulation? How would people react upon learning that our world, thoughts and emotions, are nothing more than one of millions of simulations? Jürgen Schmidhuber is a computer scientist most noted for his work in the field of artificial intelligence, deep learning, and artificial neuron networks. Since 1997, Schmidhuber has been on a self-appointed mission to prove or disprove the possibility that we all live in a computer. As long as we don't have proof that we can't compress the history of events that describes our universe into a very short program, as scientists, we are obliged to keep looking. In 2003, Swedish philosopher Nick Bostrom wrote a paper called Are You Living in a Simulation? According to Bostrom, if our descendants manage this feat sometime in the future, then the odds are that you and I are one of many copies living in a simulation rather than the base reality. His premise is based on a series of assumptions. 1. A technological society could eventually achieve the capability of creating a computer simulation that is indistinguishable from reality to the inhabitants of the simulation. 2. Such a society would not do this once or twice. They would create many such simulations. 3. Left to run long enough, the societies within the simulations would eventually be able to create their own simulations. To understand the concept of simulation hypothesis better, we can take a quick look at the history of gaming. In 1972, the first arcade game to ever receive universal acclaim was Pong. Pong is a two-dimensional sports game that simulates table tennis. In 1995, we entered the generations of 3D gaming, thanks to the 32-bit processing unit. 20 years later, we have developed games like No Man's Sky, where players are free to perform within the entirety of a generated datamestric universe, which includes over 18 quintillion planets. Running these recent games requires powerful computers and consoles. In 2014, the Harvard Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics connected 8,000 computers to create a 350 million light-year simulation of our universe and digitally aged it over 13 billion years. Today, we have Summit, a supercomputer developed by IBM, which is the fastest supercomputer in the world, capable of 200 petaflops. But even this supercomputer is unable to run detailed enough simulations. Nevertheless, it is a remarkable advancement in less than 50 years. So how about 100 or 1,000 years from now? Many experts in computer science and physics believe it will be possible to create very sophisticated simulations in the next century. Bostrom even provides a number for simulating all of human history. However, in order to run such a simulation, future societies need to build computers the size of our planet. The simulation hypothesis has had its own share of criticism as well. Lawrence Krauss, theoretical physicist, cosmologist, professor of physics, and director of the Origins Project at Arizona State University, argues that the progress of science over the last 400 years tells us there is no evidence of any plan, purpose, or intelligent design for the universe. According to him, the idea that the universe is a simulation is possible, but very unlikely. The universe could have spontaneously arisen from nothing. He makes the case that this is not only plausible, but inevitable. More on that in another video. Thank you for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.